Hi, I'm Doug, your tech support representative here at Atlantic British. And in this video, we want to introduce to you the O2 sensor replacement kit for the 99 to 2004 Land Rover Discovery 2 with the Bosch engine. The kit will give you the four sensors that you need to replace. They are recommended to be done every 90,000 miles. What they do is they get coated and they become lesser efficient as they get older. And with the lesser efficiency, it can affect the fuel economy and also the performance on your engine. Now, we have the Academy listing where you can go to our website. You can access and download the sheet. You'll see that it's Kit N, Oxygen Sensor Kit. And our part number is MHK100920SKA. And essentially what you're going to get in the kit is the two upstream and the two downstream O2 sensors. Each one comes with a small packet of Neversea, so you can coat the threads to make your installation easier. So what we're going to do is we're going to put this O2 up in the air, and we're going to take a look at underneath, and we'll show you how to access and replace the O2 sensors. All right, so we're showing you the kit now for our Repair and Maintenance Academy for your changing your O2 sensors on your Discovery 2. So what we're going to do is give you a little review of where they are and some of the tools that you can use to remove these. Now, on this particular unit, this has new catalytic converter, new O2 sensors, so everything is nice and clean. It would readily come out. One of the two that you can use, the two tools, this is in a 3/8 drive and has a cutaway so you can get around the wiring. And this will essentially just slip over the top, drop down, and lock into the O2. What's nice about it is if you got one that's a little snug, I can even tap on this with a hammer, break it loose, and then you'll see you have a slot there so that you can put a 3/8 drive breaker bar or ratchet on it. Now there's also the socket, and this is well known among a lot of technicians because you can do it one of several ways. This also has a cutaway and a slot over the wiring down onto the O2 sensor. But what's nice about it is you can put either a 1/2 inch drive ratchet or even a wrench around its outside in case you can't get a ratchet up in there, may not have enough room. Next is going to be your connector locations. Now this is one of your downstream O2 sensors, essentially downstream from the catalytic converter. If you trace and follow your wire up, you will find that in this one, your connector is up alongside the transfer case on the driver's side. And on the passenger side O2, they have the connector mounted up top of the transfer case. So you'll need to extend your arm a little bit. You depress that outer tab. You can slide the connector off of the retainer and then from there make it a lot easier to access the connector and take that off. The front O2 sensors are easier accessed as far as the connector goes from the top of the engine. We'll show you that in a moment. But the O2 itself, the upstreams, one is mounted here right next to the starter, and on the driver's side, right at below the elbow of the catalytic converter. Both are readily accessible. You can get your tools on them, you can remove them. So we're going to lower this now and we'll show you the connectors for the upstream O2 sensors, and that will give you probably a good idea what you need to do to change these over. And again, this is a good maintenance to do. This is something that every 90-100,000 miles you want to replace. They do fatigue, they do coat. The connectors, they do get some oil on them. And changing them over, you'd be surprised at what it'll do for your engine performance and for your fuel economy. All right, so for the driver's side O2 sensor, and even though it does look like it's inaccessible, it sits right here, but just behind the left side head. You can actually take a long screwdriver similar to this or a long rod. If you set it on top of the connector and give it a couple good pops, that will drop down. Your tab, retainer tab, sits right there on top of the connector, so you can actually push that in with a long screwdriver and push that down. Once you break it loose, believe it or not, it is accessible. Now the one on the passenger side is much more visible and much easier to get at. And you'll see actually this one is even off its retainer, and you can lift straight up and there's the connector right in front of you. And just to make it visible as to what you need to do to disconnect, the O2 from the harness. There's a squeeze tab right here on the connector. You will push that down. You'll actually see that inner tab lift up and release from the retainer and just simply pull apart. When you go to reinstall, simply push the two together. You'll hear a click and you know you're in. A little test pull just to make sure you have a good solid connection, and then reinstall your connector back where it belongs. You'll see these flat metal tabs that are used as the retainers for these connectors. And they actually slide into these open slots that are built on the opposite side of the connector from the release tab. And they just simply slide on. And by doing so, keeps that connector away from the exhaust system so that we don't burn any wires. And that's pretty much it for changing over the O2 sensors. Again, reasonably, it'll probably take you 45 minutes, maybe an hour, to change them over. But in the long run, well worth it. And it's definitely a recommended service by Land Rover. So when you're ready to change over your O2 sensors, just give a call to any of our knowledgeable salesmen at 1-800-533-2210.